So hi everyone. I'm Himanshali. I'm working as a tech lead DB engineering at InMobi. So today I'm, as already he told, I'm going to talk about that PostgreSQL as NoSQL. So PostgreSQL, that is a powerful open source RDBMS, right? And we are using in our company for many critical application there as a master database for that. And there is other one that is sitting there, that is NoSQL. So if you see, both are like just conflicting terms in there. So no, actually this NoSQL term, that always confuses me, because if you see PostgreSQL, if its history, that it was also not using SQL. There was something called QUEL that it was using, but we can't tell the PostgreSQL as a NoSQL database, right? Because what is the modern NoSQL DB, that is being different from existing RDBMS, right? So what I think, that is main thing, that there is a freedom of your data model, how you are defining there, right? So is schema-less, that is the main thing that is NoSQL DBs are providing. So so actually my talk is about PostgreSQL as a schema-less database, how we can use it. So so what I'm going to talk today, that is what was the requirement of schema-less database in our scenario, and what data type and volume that we had to handle, and how we can use our existing setup that is already there instead of migrating to a new NoSQL DB, and what performance this guy was providing to us when we were adopting this option there. So first of all, what is a schema-less data, right? So normally if you see, schema-less doesn't mean something that is not structured, right? When we are talking about a schema database, there is thing that we have already a predefined data model. You define your schemas, how you are going to store your data. But in this case, you get that freedom there, right? So, but still it is like here you have, instead of how in schema DBs you are, your data is row based, right? Each rows that you have already defined, on that basis, it is being stored there. But here you have a document based store, right? Where you have a key value pair, and that can be a hierarchy of arrays there, right? And the thing is, application needs to be aware about what kind of data you are going to store there. So, and even if it's like, it can be dynamic whenever it is being stored as document, because one document, whatever data is inside, that can be completely different with, for example, if you have five keys, first document, in second it can be like 25 keys, right? But yes, your application that should be able to handle that thing. So it should be whatever, how you are writing your application, it should be about, it should be aware about what keys you are going to store in your document, right? So yes, so back to what the requirement that came to us in our team. So there is already, there was an existing application that was running on PostgreSQL. Now they came with some requirement where they introduced one new entity that is called merchant. Okay, now for that, they were, the data was not what we are generating, the data was going to come from the clients. And here they were not sure about that, for now they were knowing that there can be maximum like 15 field, that they were known field, right? And even this data was not standard for all merchants. For some merchants, there can be only 5 that data can come, for some merchants it can go to 10. So in that range it was varying. And this will only be known when the data is coming from that client side, right? So for that, now they came that, okay, so this is the requirement, and in existing schema, in existing DB, how you are going to use that? So there was some solution came, right? Okay, just define a schema for that, maybe just define a table for that, in which maximum keep 15 columns there, right? And after that, if okay, tomorrow if something new comes, okay, we will go and add one more column. So it doesn't look that clean, right? Tomorrow maybe if something again, you for older merchant, you may have to go and again update the data for that new column that you are adding. So whenever it was something hacky that we could have done in there, but we thought okay, it's not that clean way, right? So, and also the data was not that small that we were expecting. So it was like to start with, they were telling that data can be like 1 million per hour. So this, like I already told, the problem with the existing thing that schema was predefined and so many null value chances were there. Whenever you are adding any new column, so you will have to do a schema change, and that will be costly if your data size is used there, and in case if you have to update the existing values. So we were thinking, so should we this report thing, should we change it to a separate module, and should we, you know, think about some NoSQL DBs where you can just go and dump your data, because that was the requirement it was looking like. So we thought, okay, because we have read about it, that PostgreSQL is providing you a document store that you can use there. So, but we were not using it. So there are three types of option that this guy is providing there. That is, one is XML, second one is called HStore, and third is JSON. So normally, I'm not going to talk about XML because I have not tested upon this, because the application that is running on Java and normally they will be, JSON format will be better for them. So what we have tested, that HStore and JSON that we tested, that if how it works there, just we did some benchmarking on that. Okay, so this first HStore, okay. So this is not a part of core PostgreSQL, okay. This is a country module that is giving you this feature for storing the document type, right? So this is giving you a where you can store your not like normal databases, how you store in row level. You can store your data in a document level, right? That's what we wanted, right? And only the better one plus thing that you are getting that what RDBMS feature, that acid compilance thing there, and you can map is whatever keys and values that are being stored as strings there, and they are even providing you some rich functions there where you can to process over data. First you just insert and to different kind of processing they are providing for it. I've just pasted here some examples, like if we H is your document there, so A is your key. So if you can just see that so what is the value of A there that you can get. In second, it is some if condition, if A is present in a document H. Other is like if A has, the key has value 2 is present in that. So such operators it is providing there. And there is even in, it is giving you indexing feature there. There are two types of indexing that it is providing, that is gist and gene. So we have tested the both indexing, how it works in when you are fetching the data from there. And whenever you create this indexing, so it is not like you have to go and create over particular keys there. Whenever you are indexing, it creates indexing is being done over a document level, and it creates indexing on each key there. So even if a normal text indexes, if in normal RDBMS how you create that, in PostgreSQL if you have a text field over that, you create expression indexes, right? So same indexes also, if you want, you can use it here if you have such requirement there. It is, I've just pasted some example, like how it is a normal extension, so there is a very simple command. You just create extension HStore, and now that extension is created in your database, and now you can use it. It's this is just like how you create table, how you are creating the index there, and some queries how you perform there. So using normal SQL, you can retrieve those values on the keys and giving some filter conditions like that. Second thing that we tested, that the second approach that Postgres is providing. So JSON, that is like I think very famous these days. So normally it was introduced in 9.2 version. That was the last stable version. Currently we have 9.3 that is there. But in 9.2 they just introduced it as a normal JSON thing. But internally, it was being stored as text only. Only thing that what it was providing, it was giving you a validation layer when you are inserting the data into table. So it will just validate, okay, it is a proper JSON format. But internally, it was storing it as a normal text. So it is not that good in performance and all. It is like a normal text storage. So whenever you are retrieving that, that query becomes very costly. So that's what the problem was with 9.2. 9.3, they gave some more new features for fetching the data and do different operations on that JSON type. But still, due to the storage, how they were doing, that's what, because I have tested, next slides I will show you the performance. So I have tested on 9.3 only. So the performance was not good due to its storage thing, how it is doing. So that's, they are going to fix in 9.4 actually, where they are introducing that JSON binary format. So now finally they are, instead of storing it as text, they are going to store it as in a formal JSON format there. So in that case, even they are giving you more indexing features there, where retrieval is going to be better there. And even some more functions are being introduced there. And other than this, for even in Edge store or JSON, if you want your performance to be some better, what there is some unlogging feature that PostgreSQL is providing. So that was also, we have tested. So normally, if you know that there is some data that is, you don't, there is two things, right? If there is whatever data that is being logged in something called X log there. So if you want key, my queries should be faster, I don't want that my data should be that, like if your server going down and you have some backup and you don't want that whenever my server is coming up, my data should be like, you know, available there. So in that case, if you are thinking about performance more than reliability, you can use your unlock feature as well. These are some functions where you can to migrate between H store to JSON if you want. Like first you just started using H store, and now like if 9.4 came and now you want to move to JSON. So these functions are being provided where that will help in fetching from H store and migrating to JSON format. So here is some testing that I did there just to convince them that if we can go with this approach there. So what data I used, that I just created one CSV file where I generated this 2 million data. And it was a normal laptop with 8 GB RAM there. And on that it was being tested. So Postgres was installed there and Mongo was installed there. And if you see the, so first thing was being test that what is the write speed there, okay. So for this, this is for 2 million. So if you see the graph that how many records per second it was being inserted there. So there was one normal edge store type there. There was other was with gist index, with gin index, and then JSON, and then Mongo. Mongo has that index on primary key there. So this was the result that it came there. So I think here Jin was the slowest in this insertion part there. And next was what volume it was taking on the disk. So if you see why the Jin was slow in the writing, if you see how it stores the data. So in that indexing size is much more than what indexing size is just. And JSON was as normal as gist here, just when you are, means writing is okay there. MongoDB size was, if we compare, it was too much for, I mean, I'm not sure how they store that data there. And then the some selection queries were performed. First one I tested on giving the filter condition on primary keys, and other was on some text key filter. So this is the result that came there. So yes. So when I'm querying on primary key, the gist and the gin, they were not good in that condition if you compare with JSON on Mongo. Next one was when the query is being fetched on any key filter, if whatever is present in the document. So in that case, gist was doing good if in comparison to if we are comparing with Mongo's time that in milliseconds. So yeah, what conclusions we got from all this testing? So yes, we can handle schema-less database here. I mean, sorry, schema-less data here. And its storage is really very efficient if you talk about that with just indexing there. And even you have some build indexes, you can build indexes on expression as well. And the basic difference that we found that what is between that gist indexing, because finally JSON we didn't find good with this version, so we thought for HStore, and in HStore you had two options. So gist was looking better for when you have the data dynamic. In that case, because retrieval is much faster in that gist indexing. So we decided to go with HStore gist there. So yeah, what you are getting in PostgreSQL here, you are normally we didn't do much changes there. Whatever was existing system, you just install the extension there. And now as normally you were using your SQL, your transaction, your constraints. Yeah, constraints is also that you can use like normal. You even you want to more layer of validation there, you can use check constraints over your that column there. And even you can do normal joins. And you are getting that schema-less features as well. And we saved our migration cost and new setup of NoSQL DBs. And only problem here is that these all are not RDBMS given feature, but it is only for PostgreSQL. So now if you tomorrow you want to migrate to some other RDBMS or something, so that is not possible. In that case, you need to move to NoSQL for at least this reporting part. Yeah. Thank you. Any questions?
Quick question. Yeah. So you spoke about HStore, and I saw in one of your initial slides you had 1 million row per second or something that said 1 million per hour.
Yeah, that is the production requirement when the application came that this will be the data that they were expecting.
Okay.
This is what a graph I'm showing the when we tested that with this much data.
Okay. So your HStore is going to require some storage system, right? Because looks like you're probably getting a lot of data. And how do you store it? Is it backed up with SAN, internal disk, or
it is on normal disk?
Internal disk.
Yes.
And
managing that much data, even we introduce their table partitioning, right? Hourly thing. Mm-hmm. So normally it is like every hour we have one partition there.
Okay.
So normally the data comes and data is coming in format of CSV file. So we are managing that that CSV file should have that hour mentioned, and normally it is directly going to into that partition there.
Okay. That's and right. When you need to do your cleanup, because
yes.
You're talking document store,
yes.
Now, right? It's
yes.
Not like any RDBMS
yes.
System where
yes.
Cleanups are very easy to work on.
Yeah.
How easy are, you know, are there challenges in keeping your database cleaned up, right?
So in our case, it is normal, you want to keep data for 7 days. And in that case, you just go and delete the old partition. That's what we are
That's
doing.
All. That's okay. All it's basically date yes. Range partition system
yes.
That you maintain.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Thanks.
Till what volume of data have you seen the performance to be stable?
Sorry?
Till what volume, how many GBs of data have you seen the performance to be constant, to be predictable?
So as I told already, we are just keeping data for 7 days there. And normally the query that this time is happening, you have indexes on each partition there. So till now, actually, it is working good. We have not
So for 7 days... around how much data would be there?
It will be around 75 GB.
75 GB.
Yes.
Okay.